Welcome to Sam's Disney Diary, episode number 27. I was lucky enough to experience the Epcot World Showcase Segway Tour, both in June of 2012, the Around the World Segway Tour, and again in November 2012, the Keep Moving Forward, See the World, Share a Dream Segway Tour. I had planned to blog about the differences when Disney unexpectedly canceled the World Showcase tours. No reason was given, but I do hope that they come back soon. This video features some of the differences and some of the actual tour. Hope you enjoy. For more information on the differences, check out the podcast on iTunes and head to samsdisneydiary.com.
Welcome back to Sam's Disney Diary. This morning we're here at Epcot. As opposed to running into the park, grabbing a Soarin' Fast Pass and maybe Test Track in the countries, wanted to do things a little bit different. Step back a minute, do a Disney tour. This morning, we're going to get on Segways and go through World Showcase and the World Showcase Segway Tour. This is going to be good.
Being in Epcot before rope drop allowed for some pretty interesting pictures of an empty Epcot. After we took some pictures, we head to Guest Relations. There at Guest Relations, you sign your waivers, prepare for the tour, and specifically for the Keep Moving Forward tour, we were able to select a breakfast option. That's new from the original tour and was a nice touch. Option one, breakfast platter, looks good to me. The tour itself is broken into two sections. First is training on the operation of the Segway vehicle, and second, the tour itself. After we picked breakfast, it was off to the training. It's a short walk to Innoventions West and Segway Central. The first step is being fitted for a helmet and sitting down for the safety video. Here's a little bit of that video.
Experience the fun of the World Showcase while riding the Segway personal transporter. Your experience will be divided into two sections. In the first section, you will learn to operate the Segway personal transporter. In the second section, you will ride the Segway PT around the World Showcase. We need to cover several items before we get started. Here are some of the guidelines that have been established for your safety. All participants must meet Segway operator requirements for the Segway PT. Be at least 16 years of age. You must always ride under control and be prepared to slow and stop safely. But most of all, we want you to have a wonderful time as you ride your Segway around the world at Epcot.
All right, now I'm going to talk a little bit about those opt-out options, of which there are three. The first one is yours. At any time, if this is not the experience while we're in the classroom that you thought it was going to be and you're not having fun and you just want to say, I'm done, you guys, it's not a problem. You just go to Guest Relations and they're going to make you happy. The second one is also your opt-out option. While we're in the World Showcase, we just do some minor challenges. We go up some ramps and down some ramps and are slalom through some Grecian columns. None of those do you have to do. If you don't feel comfortable, just hang back with me and you're not under any obligation. It's your tour, we want you to have fun. And seeing the World Showcase before it opens is really an experience. You're going to get pictures with just you in it, which is just amazing when you're here at Epcot, because other than the workers out there, we're going to be the only ones out there on tour. Now the third opt-out option is one that I don't like to use, but it does happen occasionally, and that's my opt-out option. If at any time I feel you're unsafe, maybe you're riding a little aggressively, or you're just real tentative and I fear for your safety, I can opt you out and just say, you know what, this isn't a good thing. Because, you know, that's my job, is to keep us safe and to make sure everyone is safe. And this is a large tour. We got a big tour, so we all got to be on our toes and we're all going to have a good time out there.
After the safety video, it was time to step on the Segway PTs. A lot like riding the bicycle, once you step on and get the hang of it, you're simply standing and leaning to maneuver. At the end of the day, the Segway becomes our transportation around World Showcase for the tour itself. After we finished our training, some obstacles, up and down hills, we headed from Innoventions West over towards the Imagination Pavilion. Obviously, this video is sped up a little bit for the sake of time. But one thing that you'll notice, when we finished our training, Future World was opened. So there were guests inside of Epcot. which made it a little tricky, but not that bad at the early morning hour, leaving Interventions and headed towards the Imagination Pavilion. Now, this was new in the Keep Moving Forward tour versus the Around the World tour. In the Around the World tour, we simply headed directly towards World Showcase. In this tour, we headed to a backstage area behind the Imagination Pavilion that led us to a back door area into the Land Pavilion. This put us very close to the restrooms and Soarin'. At this point, we were able to park the Segways, go into the pavilion, and enjoy the breakfast that we had selected earlier. A pretty nice change from the original tour, which went straight out into World Showcase. After a quick stop at the restroom, we were escorted to a reserved section of Sunshine Seasons, where we were served the breakfast that we had ordered previously. As we left, it was hard not to notice Soarin' and the Fast Pass machines. So obviously, we grabbed the Fast Pass, which may come in handy after the tour. Finally, time to start our World Showcase tour. Back onto the Segways, we'll head towards World Showcase, the Mexican side, through an already opened Future World. There are two big differences in the Around the World Segway tour from June and the Keep Moving Forward tour in November. One being the breakfast, and the second being an earpiece that you wore to listen to your tour guide. So the tour guide could talk to you throughout your tour, even when you were moving, and everyone in the group could hear what was being said. Another big difference was, in November, it was Food and Wine Festival. There was a lot more activity, a lot more booths around World Showcase, and it was more difficult to get through some areas. You'll notice that we went right past Mexico, which isn't yet opened, and we're also going right past Norway, which is only opened for the Princess Storybook Dining at Akershus Royal Banquet Hall. Once we hit China, a cast member opens the rope, and we're able to go into the yet-to-be-opened World Showcase. This is the first stop on the tour. Ride the Segways deep into the Chinese pavilion, then gather around the tour guide while the tour guide gives us some interesting facts about the pavilion. Now, this is the tour from June before the headpieces. This is also your opportunity to go on the tour.
So here we are in China. Obviously, our World Showcase is not open, so it offers you a new perspective. And as you look around and you look at the beautiful area, we like to kind of think of our World Showcase almost as a movie set. So you look around and you see the set. Now obviously China is one of the world's oldest cultures and oldest countries, so there was a lot of things we could have chosen when we chose our pavilion here. Well, we had to narrow it down and pick a couple different landmarks. So behind us we have the Imperial Palace, and then over here we're going to go ride by the Temple of Heaven Park, which is a temple where they go for prayer. The emperor will go for prayer in hopes of a good harvest. And now if you look up on the roof here, I know it's kind of hard with the sun, but take a little look. The little guy that's sitting on that little statue there, that is Prince Min. Now, he was an emperor in the Chinese dynasty, but he was a pretty nasty guy. He actually was eventually hanged by his people because of the cruelty that he inflicted on them. And he is on a chicken. Most of the time when the emperors were riding off into their next destiny, they would be on things like a dragon. Because he was so awful, they put him on a chicken, kind of as an embarrassing goat. And behind him are the little dragons in place to keep him on the rooftop forever, so he never gets to go off into his next adventure. Behind us, kind of where Carl is standing, we have our Foo Dogs, or our Foo Lions. They are mythical creatures that usually mark the entrance to the different shrines and temples in China. And they always come in a pair, as a male and as a female. The male is on this side. He has his paw on the ball, representing the world. And then his female companion has her paw on the cub, and obviously cub, motherly instinct. He represents command and authority. She represents protection and loyalty. Together, they bring good luck and good fortune to those around them. So today, we're going to need just a little bit of that, because not only is this a really great Segway tour, it's also your challenge. We have a lot of great tests and challenges all out in the World Showcase to make this a really fun and enjoyable experience for you guys. And you guys are doing excellent, so we're going to start it off with one of our harder challenges, but it's simple for you guys. Because remember that ramp that Jan taught you guys how to go down in the classroom? That's what we're doing over here. So a few differences. This one's all concrete. If you get so distracted, you could end up in the pond, so we don't want to do that. So pay attention. Keep your Segway nice and straight in the center. center of the path. I believe either Jan or Robert is at the bottom there, so please don't run them over. Kind of need them for the rest of the tour. And what we'll do is I will go down first, just follow behind me. It's honestly really easy. Just keep your Segway in the center. And what I'll do is I'll get down there and I'll stop and I'll wait for everyone to finish before moving on, okay?
After a quick challenge in China, it was off to Germany for our second stop. I'll speed up the video to get us there even quicker. What I liked most about getting from country to country was not taking a straight line. We went around things, through things, into small nooks and crannies of World Showcase that I can't wait to get back to on foot. Let's pick up the tour with the tour guide in Germany.
So welcome to Germany. This is our German pavilion, and it represents the town of Rutenberg, which is a little tourist city now along the Romantic Road. Now, the German culture is very influential to the Disney culture, actually. Walt Disney and his wife Lillian would often vacation over in Germany. And when they were there, you know, traveling the Romantic Road, Walt Disney was really inspired by the castles, especially the new Schwanstein Castle over in Germany. That was the inspiration for the Disneyland Castle, Sleeping Beauty Castle, and then for Cinderella Castle. And so this architecture you see around us is Bavarian architecture. And it can also be found one another place at Walt Disney World. Any guesses as to where?
Fantasyland.
Perfect, exactly, Daniel. And Fantasyland over in It's a Small World, Pinocchio's Village House. It's kind of being thrown off by all the construction we have going on in Fantasyland, but yes. So obviously the German culture and countryside heavily inspired our little town here. Now, the Romantic Road is a 220-mile stretch of road connecting the towns of Fusen to the towns of Wurzburg. And we actually have our own little model replica of the Romantic Road here in Germany. It's right around the corner on the left. Now, it's one of my favorite obstacles, so I hope we have the chance to do it. No, we don't have the chance to do it. I think they're gardening. But what we'll do at least, we'll get to drive by it. You may, this duck is apparently going to join our Segway tour. Hey, buddy. Come on in. Donald. Look at that. That's cute. They're all beginners here, so you better be careful. But the Romantic Road model that we'll at least drive by was originally part of the 1995 International Flower and Garden Festival, and was not supposed to say, but all of the guests loved it, and it's still here to this day, and we will model it and design it during the different times of the year. So it celebrates Christmas, it celebrates Food and Wine Festival, celebrates all of the different things going on here at Epcot. So we're going to go around. I saw a hose, so I'm going to try and get us around it safely without having to waste time getting off the Segway, but it might come to that. So we'll go scope it out together, okay?
Even though I did participate in two separate tours, I can definitely say they were two different experiences. A lot of the information was the same, but in this case, the Romantic Road that we had been talking about is the train display between Germany and Italy. Today, that was being gardened. You could see the gardeners, you could see a lot of their equipment, and we couldn't quite go into that display. However, the tour in November, we absolutely were able to go right up in there. You also notice a limousine straight ahead in the middle of Italy. A wedding party getting wedding pictures in Italy before World Showcase opens. That limited what we could do in Italy a little, but it was cool to see what was happening.
Our next challenge is right up ahead. We're gonna weave in and out of the columns of the building, okay? So you guys are riding great, so yes, columns there. Great obstacle, but more, a little bit more meaning than that. Those are the columns of the Doge's Palace. So we here are in St. Mark's Square in Venice, Italy. Has anyone ever been to St. Mark's Square? No, never. Well, that's good to know, because you won't know that we kind of deceived you just a little bit. Our version of St. Mark's Square is actually an exact mirror image of the actual St. Mark's Square. Because when our Imagineers were planning for it, they all were using slides in a presentation that they would, you know, put up against the wall to show what St. Mark's Square looked like. Well, one of the Imagineers might have accidentally put in the slide backwards, and so they threw up all of their beautiful plans for St. Mark's Square and then realized that the slide was backwards. But Disney, we are known for our creative vision, and they actually learned and saw that it looked more authentic and a little bit more beautiful in our World Showcase and more aesthetically pleasing being a mirror image. So why change something that works for us? So if you were to go over and take St. Michael's Square, the campanile would be on the opposite side of the promenade, and these columns would also be flipped, and our Doge's Palace would be on the other side. So, kind of authentic, but just a little bit of Disney spin and imagination on it. Now behind me is the campanile. This is our bell tower. It stood for over 1,000 years in St. Mark's Square in Venice, Italy, and then it suddenly collapsed in 1902. However, all the way atop, there is an angel. She has her little twin sister over there behind the umbrella, too, so you can see her there. When it collapsed, the angel survived. She did not have a scratch on her. So the locals all thought that to be a miracle, and they decided to rebuild the bell tower. It took them about 10 years, and then in 1912, they had a grand reopening ceremony. So it rings for different symbolism throughout the day. There's a bell to mark the beginning and the end of the workday, a bell that rings for the ninth hour. There is a bell to call the senators and the magistrates to the Doge's Palace. And then there is a soft, sweet-sounding bell that you would not want to hear if you were in St. Mark's Square, because it was actually for capital execution. Believe it or not, they would hold public capital executions there in the St. Mark's Square, and they would take place between the two columns behind us. So in the spirit of the good luck that the Foo Dogs brought us, we do not take our segways between the columns. We will be going around them. And we are heading over to the little free ride area that Jan is setting up. This is the perfect spot for you to take some photos. If you step off your Segway and you grab your camera and hand it to myself, to Jan, or even to Robert, we'll take some pictures of you on your Segway. We position you right in, kind of in the back so you get a nice view of Spaceship Earth. And if you'd like to turn, we can also position you so you see Italy, but that one was kind of in the way. And this is also your opportunity to step off your Segway. You might need to rest your legs, get a little bit of drink of water. If you do that, just like in the bathroom, you want to step off your Segway and walk it to the wall, and then you can kind of walk around and stretch out.
Which wall?
Also, wherever you can find, yeah. Also, you are able to ride around a little bit. We're not going to be here long because we're running short on time, and I want to get lots of riding in for you guys. But if you want to ride around in the area, just do it safely because obviously people are going to be walking around, okay? So I'll go out this way.
One thing that was consistent in both tours was the rest stop after Italy. We parked our Segways, we were able to stretch our legs out.
This is cool.
Give our cameras to the tour guides who took pictures of us with Spaceship Earth in the background. These are the pictures that you see from everyone that's gone on the Segway tour. It's the only place where you can officially use your camera. I was able to take video because I had mounted my camera to the handlebars of the Segway. At no point in time are you allowed to take a hand off of the Segway to snap a picture. In fact, your camera was in your pocket, or in my case, mounted to the Segway itself.
Segway tour and World Showcase. This is pretty cool. Get to ride around World Showcase with nobody here. It's also food and wine, so we get to see some of the booths. Go behind the scenes a little bit. Some great information on the tour. We're halfway through. Get ready to finish up.
Italy was a busy place for both of my tours. In June 2012, there was a wedding party, and in November 2012, they were filming a food and wine festival commercial for the 2013 Food and Wine Festival. Pretty cool to see in action. Time to continue the tour. Back onto the Segways, through an obstacle course in the American Adventure, and on to our next stop, Japan.
Castle, because it's so simple, it's like a white heron. Use your imagination. Another reason I really, really like this pavilion is the beautiful Serenity Garden with the koi pond in front right there. And as you can see, Jan just scooted on up there because this is also my favorite challenge.
The Segway Challenge in Japan was absolutely the best. Riding the Segway up and around the Japanese gardens, over the bridges, and back down made for an absolutely beautiful scene. The video here is sped up a little bit for the sake of time, but you get the idea and get the picture. Nobody in Japan except for you and the others in your Segway tour. After leaving Japan, the next stop on the tour, Morocco. We took the Segways deep into Morocco, exploring lots of small spaces, nooks and crannies to the pavilion. After Morocco, it's off to France, the last of the World Showcase pavilions that still has not opened. As our tour was wrapping up, World Showcase was opening. This is the rope drop near France as the crowds start to come in the World Showcase. And we're headed back to Innoventions West through the crowds. Let's speed it up just a little bit. On the way back, we maneuvered the crowds, went straight through the United Kingdom, straight through Canada, back towards Innoventions West. Headed towards Spaceship Earth with the crowd coming towards you was pretty cool. You could hear lots of people commenting on the segways and how much they wanted to do the tour in the future. Let's hope that the tour comes back so that everybody can do it. The tour ends where it began, back in Innoventions West at Segway Central. We maneuver the crowds through Innoventions, make our way back to Segway Central where we park the segways, replace our helmets, and have a seat in the theater where it all started. At the conclusion, you get your limited edition Segway pin. I have both the Around the World Segway pin and the Keep Moving Forward, See the World, Share a Dream Segway pin. As we leave Innoventions West, we realize we have a fast pass for Soarin', and the standby line's about 100 minutes. Perfect timing. Overall, I really enjoyed both of the Segway tours. The Segway was really a means to move around the World Showcase quickly so that you could learn about the pavilions. I only wish that we had the opportunity to stop in Mexico, Norway, Canada, and the United Kingdom. Now, Disney did recently cancel all of the World Showcase Segway tours. You can still ride a Segway over at Fort Wilderness, but I do hope the World Showcase tour comes back. It was a lot of fun and something I would definitely do again. Thanks for watching Sam's Disney Diary. For all of the latest, visit the blog at samsdisneydiary.com. You'll find the podcast over on iTunes, Sam's Disney Diary. I have some more details on the Segway tour there. And of course, drop me an email, samsdisneydiary@mel.com. Follow me on Twitter, @samsdisneydiary, and facebook.com/samsdisneydiary. If you ever experienced the Segway tour, I'm interested in what your experience was like. And if you notice that it's coming again, please let me know. Until then, have a great day, and we'll see you next time on Sam's Disney Diary.